Good afternoon, everyone. Now we are going to discuss today test paper solution. In our first question is given f of x or root of 10 minus x square minus 3 less than x less than 3, 2 minus e power x minus 3 if x greater than or equal to 3. Where at x equal to 3, we need to check for continuous and differentiable. Now, if you find out LHL value, it is limit extends to 3 minus less than 3. What is the function is there? It is root of 10 minus x square. Here, what we'll get here? That is root of 10 minus 3 square 9, that is 1. Similarly, RHL, right hand limit extends to 3 plus more than 3. What is the function? 2 minus e power x minus 3 minus e power 3 minus 0. E power 0 is 1, 2 minus 1 is 1. That's why f is clearly continuous. Where x equal to 3. Now I'm finding f dash of x, derivating the function, root derivative 1 by 2 root of 10 minus x square, and inner function derivative minus 2x, 2 to cancel, we get minus x by root of 10 minus x square. That minus x less than 3, derivative 0, e power x minus 3 derivative, e power x minus 3. If you substitute right, left hand derivative, substitute x value 3, that is minus 3 by denominator, I think 1 is possible, that is minus 3. Next right hand derivative, that is e power minus, this is 3, 3 minus 3, 0. This is how much? Minus 1. LHG is not equal to RH, therefore f is not differentiable. Where x equal to, that's why f is continuous but not differentiable. That's why option 2 is the correct one. Next, you know, second question. Come to the solution. Greatest and least absolute values of z plus 1, they're asking, where mod of z plus 1 less than or equal to 3 are respectively. Okay, now first this mod of z plus 4 or 3 we can take. Z plus 1, this we can write mod of z plus 4 minus 3. We have formula mod of z1 minus z2 is less than or equal to modulus of mod z1 minus mod z2. Okay, as for that, I'm taking the values here. This is mod of mod z plus 4 becomes what here? Less than or equal to whole modulus minus mod of 3 we can take, or minus 3 if you take plus symbol, minus symbol for everything, it will be satisfied. Okay, now as for that, minus mod. So mod of z plus 4 less than or equal to almost 3, already we know the condition wise what you are taking. If you take here plus, here also the symbol, what you will get here? Plus 1. Here like that, we are taking this plus of, we are taking which one? Minus 3. This z2 we are taking as minus 3. Now mod of z plus 4 less than or equal to almost 3, that's why this 3, mod of minus 3 also 3. That's why we got greatest value for this. Mod of z plus 1 is less than or equal to 6. There is a greatest value we got. Next, we need to find least value. Okay. Now, to find the least value, that's what we are taking now. So, mod of z plus 4. In this mod of z plus 4, now it is, we can write mod of z plus 1 plus 3. Mod of z plus 1 plus 3. Mod of z1 plus z3, what you can take here, this is clearly, again, this term is less than or equal to this value. Now when plus is there, now what you are taking? Mod of z plus 1 plus mod of 3 is 3. So mod of z plus 4 is clearly 3. Is 3. 3 less than or equal to mod of z plus 1 plus 3. 3 cancel. From this, what we can write? mod of z plus 1 is greater than or equal to 0. That means greatest value, greatest is 6, least is 0. That's why first option is correct. Next, see in third one, 5x minus 1 whole square, 5y minus 2 whole square is equal to lambda square minus 4 lambda plus 4 into 3x plus 4y minus 1 whole square represents a ellipse. Now when it is represents ellipse means as a condition SP for any conic section SP is equal to PE into PM where eccentricity lies in between 0 to 1. Now we need to change it in that form. Okay, for that I am taking what here? Now what is the value? Equation. In this equation, I am taking 5 is common. Here also take 5 common. By taking 5 common, while coming outside, what will get? 25. That is x minus 1 by 5 whole square. Next, y minus 2 by 5 whole square is equal to this whole value. I can write lambda minus 2 whole square to 3x plus 4y minus 1 whole square. Okay. Now this 25 centered side, x minus 1 by 5 whole square plus y minus 2 by 5 whole square, lambda minus 2 whole square into 3x plus 4y minus 1 whole square by 25 whole square. 25 only, okay? So we have what? Only 25. But SP means distance between two points. PM nothing but if you take any conic section, generally what we are taking, there is a fixed point S here somewhere. There is a directrix here. This is a P point. This P point is on the any conic. Now SP, perpendicular distance of directrix, PM. SP by PM is in the constant range, is E. Depending on E value, different conics will get. Okay. Now to get distance, I'm taking square root on both sides. Root of x minus 1 by 5 whole square plus y minus 2 by 5 whole square is equal to, we're taking root, square root, square is cancelled. 3x plus 4y minus 1 by 5. This distance between two points now point to the directrix. That's why it is SP equal to E into PM. In the place of E, what is there? Lambda minus 2. We know the eccentricity value lies in between for ellipse. 0 less than lambda minus 2 less than 1. So we need to find lambda range minus 2 send this side. 2 less than lambda less than 3. That's why lambda clearly belongs to open interval 2 comma 3. Okay, which option is correct? That is option 3 is the correct one. Next, question number 4. Minus 4 comma 5 is one vertex. And the 7x minus 5 is one diagonal of square, then equation of second diagonal. In square, generally, diagonals are perpendicular. That's why now equation of another diagonal. Another diagonal perpendicular to given diagonal, that is 7x minus 5 plus 8 equal to 0. Generally, a line perpendicular to ax plus by plus c equal to perpendicular line is easily we can write bx minus ay plus k equal to 0. It will be nothing but minus 1, that is minus x minus 7y plus k equal to 0. Now, this is clearly passing through which point? It is passing through a given point is there. Now one vertex, it is a one diagonal already there. That's why the point must be lying on the required diagonal. X value minus 4, that is plus 4, minus 35, plus k equal to 0. Now from this k value, how much you will get? 31. So equation of other diagonal is minus x minus 7y. Plus 31 equal to 0. From this minus x minus 7y is equal to minus 31. Multiply with minus, we'll get x plus 7y is equal to 31. That is option 3 is the correct one. Next, question number 5. in this, which of the following always true? I am going directly this truth table. Negation of P implies Q is equivalent to P and the negation Q. You can verify like that every value by using truth table. Also, we can prove true, 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 false, false, true, false, false. We need P already is there. Negation Q, find out false, true, false, true. For this true, we need to find out P imply P and the negation Q, find out true, false. False only. True and true. Yes, it is true. False, false. Next, what is a P implies Q? We know already P implies Q, TF, TT will get. Negation of this. Negation means what here? False, true, false, false. You see, in these two are equivalent to linear. That's why a third option is correct. Okay, next. Coming to sixth one. We need to integrate this value. Now, how to integrate? You see, all of you. Integral e power sin x divided with cos square, no? What will you get? X cos x sin by cos tan x into 1 by cos secant. Total secant x into tan x will get into what will you get here? Dx. Okay, now need to this one take inside integral x into e power sin x into cos x dx minus integral e power sin x into secant x into tan x dx. Generally, if you differentiate e power sin x, what we get? E power sin x into sin x derivative, because this is total derivative of which one? Derivative of which one? E power sin x. We can take like this, whole derivative. E power sin x into derivative of secant x is what? Secant x into tan x. This is what? Derivative of secant x. Okay. Now, we are applying UV form. This is U. This is V dash. This is now for easy purpose. This is take U, this is take V dash. Okay, integral U V dash formula is what? U V minus integral U dash V. Okay, now to find V dash, we need to integrate this. Okay, so X integral of derivative of e power sin x minus U dash, that is X derivative 1, integral derivative of e power sin x into dx minus of e power sin x u into integral of derivative. Now derivative integral cancel minus e power sin x derivative is e power sin x into cos x integral d derivative of secant x dx. Okay. Now your derivative integration cancel. Derivation integration cancel. Now here what? X minus x into e power sin x minus integral of e power sin x dx. Minus multiply inside. E power sin x, derivative integration cancel, only secant x will get, minus into minus plus, derivation integration cancel, e power sin x into, again cos x into sin x, cos into, because cos and secant are reciprocal to each other, so this is negative, sorry, this is positive value, this is negative value, both gets cancel, complete integral symbol is eliminated, that's why final answer is x into e power sin x minus e power sin x into secant x plus c. Now this is the answer. You see options x into e power sin x. First option is correct. Next, number 7. Function f maps whose interval 2 comma infinity tends to open interval 0 comma infinity defined by the function. What is the function is given? X square minus 4x plus a. Then the set of values of a for which f of x becomes a into function. Now first I will make this function is perfect squares. For that, x square minus 4x, I'm adding 4 and subtracting 4. This whole value we can write x minus 2 whole square plus a minus 4. Here clearly we know that x minus 2 whole square is greater than or equal to 0. Okay. Now it is always positive. That means whenever this is positive value, domain we know greater than or equal to 0 means from this x greater than or equal to 2, then x belongs to closed interval 2 comma infinity. Already is there. At x value 2, take it is 0 will come. Now to get exactly zero, here zero is not included. That's why we can't, that means this must be not a zero value. Okay, we have to get more than that. That's where a minus 4 must be only greater than 0. For example, at x value 2, if a minus 4 also take 0, what will happen? Total value 0 will come. That means at this value, range, codomain range, element range is 0 we need to get. But here, 0 is not included. That's why a minus 4 must be only greater than 0. We can't take 0 also. Okay. If you take negative also, it will be won't satisfy. That's why the value must be only greater than 0. That's why here a greater than 4. A greater than 4 means integral I will write from 4 comma infinity. Open interval 4 comma infinity is the correct one. That's why option 1 is the correct one. Don't take 4. If you take 4, the codomain nature is changes. Next, number 8. Alpha, beta are real roots of the equation x square minus 2 k minus 2x plus k square 3k plus 5 for 0 when k belongs to R. Find the maximum minimum values of beta. Okay, directly we can't simplify. Here having the real roots only, that's why now for every real roots, discriminant must be greater than or equal to 0. Now here a value 1, now b value k minus 2, c value k square minus 3k plus 5 is there. Now b square minus 4 is, that is k minus 2 whole square minus 4 a 1, a value 1 into k square plus 3k plus 5 greater than or equal to 0. Expand this, k square plus 4 minus 4k minus 4k square minus 12k minus 20 greater than or equal to 0. Now this total value you will get minus 3k square minus 16k and minus 16 greater than or equal to 0. But multiplying with minus, this will becomes plus. Inequality sign changes. If you make factors, what are the factors you will get here? 3k plus 4, 12, 48 more, 12, 4, 0, okay? Into k plus 4 less than or equal to 0. You take k common in this case, or 3 common, by sending that side, what will you get? Now k plus of 4 by 3 into k plus 4 less than or equal to 0. Now as for this condition, you will take now actual values, okay? They're asking which one, alpha square and beta square. Now alpha and beta are the roots, means sum of the roots formula, that is minus b by a. What is a b? K minus 2, that is a minus k minus 2 ma. Here minus or minus plus k minus 2 by 1, k minus 2. Alpha into beta, what will get? Alpha beta. Now alpha beta, exactly will get the product of the c by a, that is a k square plus 3k plus 5 by a value 1, no problem. Now we need to find which one, alpha square plus beta square, maximum minimum value. For easy purpose, this whole value will take some point. Okay. Now this alpha square plus beta square, I can write in terms of a plus b whole square minus a minus b, a into b. Okay. This simple equation, nothing but alpha square plus beta square. We know already alpha plus beta will how much? K minus 2 whole square minus 2 multiply for this one, minus 2k square minus 6k minus 10. Okay. By expanding this, what? K square plus 4 minus 4k minus 2k square minus 6k minus 10. Now from this, minus k square minus 10k minus 6. Okay. Now in this, take whole value minus is common, k square plus 10k plus 6. Now we need to make perfect square. In this case now, to make perfect square, too easy to get value, I am taking here in this case. Now to get maximum or minimum, where it is maximum, where it is minimum, we can identify easily. Now for easy purpose, you can take another simplified value. Now I'll make this perfect square. For that, 10 half is what? 5. That 5 square adding and subtracting to make perfect square. This whole value becomes k plus 5 whole square. Now this is minus 19 minus or minus plus 19. Total we can write this is 19 minus k plus 5 whole square. This is which one? Y value. Now where this y is minimum or maximum, we need to identify. Already we got these two values. Okay. Now y will get, y is, because both are negative terms are getting, when negative terms means k is will get k is minimum at the k value minus 4 by 3. Okay, because this is the highest value. If k is negative, the highest value, take the value, whole value becomes less. Okay, y is equal to 19 minus minus 4 by 3 plus 5. Minus 4 by 3 plus 5 means what? 11 by 3 whole square. Now that is a 19 minus 121 by 9. Take LCM. 19 into 9, that is 171 minus 121 by 9, that is 50 by 9 will get. Next, similarly, y is maximum at the remaining value, because k value you're taking least value. So least value means that because of whole square, this will become maximum. Okay. So y is equal to 19 minus minus 4 plus 5, that is 1. 19 minus 1, 18. That's why maximum is 18, minimum is 9. It is option 1 is the correct one. Okay. Next. Over next question. Question number 9. The sum of coefficients of all terms of the expansion 2x minus y as z to whole power 20 in which y do not appear. That means the power must be 0. X appears in even powers. Z appears in odd powers. Okay. Generally, it's a multinomial theorem. Any term expansion x plus y plus z whole power n. Now for this, what is the general term? We'll take general term is en, that is tr plus 1 is 20, or sorry, you know, 10 is a general in the question. Where n C of, what are the terms we will take? If we take x power is a, y power is b, that means we'll take n factorial by a factorial into, I feel clear level right now. General term is n factorial by a factorial into b factorial into c factorial into x power a, y power b, z power. Where if we take add this all powers, a plus b plus c must be equal to n, and every a value b value lies in between 0 to n only. As for that, here what is the term is given? 2x minus y plus z whole power 20. That means general term is what? 20 factorial by, for example, we don't know some value. We take a factorial, next b factorial and c factorial into x means what here? 2x power a, y means minus y whole power b, z means z only power c. Here clearly b must be 0 too, because y do not contain in that, just b must be 0. Generally what you take here, a plus b plus c must be equal to 0. B or 0 means a plus c is equal to 20, but what they given x power? X power is a even number. A is even, c is odd power. So a, c is odd. If you add even plus odd, you get even number? No. So no, never even. But actually what we need to get as per condition, 20 is even number. That's why no such coefficients are there. That's why no such coefficients present in the expansion. So what they're asking here, some of the such coefficients is what here clearly? 0, that's the first option is correct. Next. Question number 10. Now 10th question. All 5 digits in which each successive digit is a predecessor. Who, if you take next number, is a clearly is successive means increasing pattern. Before number 2, 3. Next, after 3, 4, any other number we can take. Okay, now some continuation. 4, we can't take again 2. Okay, no? Increase in the pattern here. Not increase in that also. 5 digit numbers. So, 105th number we need to find it in 5 digit numbers. Okay, now generally what we have digits here, don't take 0 in this case. I'm taking, starting with 0, we are not taking 1 to 9 generally. That's why I'm not including 0 also. Okay. For example, this start with 1. Now, 1 means remaining what numbers will take here? I mean, 4 places now. I can take either 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now, only at the total 8. 8 we need to 8 we need to select and we need to take in this case. Now, out of 8, we need to choose only 4. Now, by choosing 8, C4, what will you get? 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 by 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Now 4 into 2, 8 cancel. 3 ones are 3 threes are. Here what? 7 threes are 21. 20, generally what you are taking is fairly value wise. Condition 8 C4 na 8, 7, 6, 5. In that case, 8 C4, 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 by 2 are 8, cancel. 3 1s are now. Now 3 1s are means here 2 will come. Okay. Now here 2 5s are 10, 10 7s are 70. Okay. This is not here 2, 105th. Next. If that number start with 2, if you take next possible. Fixing 2 here. Remaining 4 places, we can't take 1 here. Remaining 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. How many are there among 7? Out of 7, we need to select how many? Only 4. So 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 by 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. 4, 4 cancel. 3 to the 6 also cancel. This is how much? 35. Now, what is this sum we will get? Now, clearly 70 plus 35. Now 75 plus 35, 105. Now already 105th word we reached, but that is a must be a number start with 2. That is a highest number start with 2. Highest number start with 2 means if I take 3, 4, 5, it won't give. If I take with 4, 5, 6, no. If you take with 5, 6, 7, 8, no. If you take last combination only, that is a last number start with 2, that is a 105th word. And that's why finally we can write what here? 105th number. Why are not taking 3, 4, 5 reason? If it takes all combination, we need to, that is the last number, start with 2. Okay, that's why what is the last number? 2, 6, 7, 8, 9. In this number, which digit is not there? Now you see in options, 1, 2 is there, 6 is there, which is not there? 1. That's why 1 is not there. This is the solution for this question. Okay. All 5 digit numbers in which each successive digits is precedent are arranged in increasing order. The 105th number does not contain the digit is what here? Only first digit is not there. For that, solution is there in previous. Okay. Next. Question number 11. It's 11th question. A comma B cap C cap are non-zero unit non-coplanar unit vector. That means all magnitudes are 1. That box product is clearly not equal to 0. Here A cap cross B cap cross B cap plus C cap is equal to 1 by root 2 multiply inside 1 by root 2 B cap plus 1 by root 2 C cap. We need to find angle between A cap and B cap. This is a vector product, dot product, first vector dot third vector into second vector minus next first vector dot second vector into third vector is equal to 1 by root 2 B cap plus 1 by root 2 C cap. But we need the term with respect to A bar and B bar only. That's why I'm not taking B cap coefficient. I'm taking only C cap coefficient only. Comparing. Now what's the coefficient in right side? 1 by root. Now this is like A dot B. A bar dot B bar formula. Mod A bar into mod B bar into cos theta is equal to 1 by root 2. Mod A cap B, mod B cap is 1. Remaining cos theta send minus on that side. Cos negative in which quadrant? Second quadrant. Second quadrant. pi minus theta, pi minus where 1 by root of pi by 4. That's why theta clearly what? 3 pi by 4. That is option 1 is the correct one. Okay. Next, question number 12. 12th question is same model of question number 2 more. Okay. You can see that is a question number I'll show you. Yeah, second question model only, okay? You can try this. What small difference will be there? You need to think and solve. Okay, next, 13th one. 13th one, okay. PQR is given the 3 points. The equation of bisector of angle PQR. Angle PQR. Now when angle PQR is there, now I am taking two set of values in this case. The triangle Y is what we are taking. Here, what is the triangle which is there? Okay, first point, what are they given? The first point, P is clearly minus 1, comma 0. Q is 0, comma 0. R is 3 comma 3 root 3. Okay, now in this case, now take diagram correctly, you can understand. This is y axis. So I'm taking x axis. And one point is origin, one point is P, no problem. Later we can take. I'm joining from this origin to another point I'm taking. Okay. Now, this is origin Q point. Q is 0, comma 0. P minus 1, comma 0. This is R. 3, comma 3 root 3. Now, join these two also. P point and Q point. Now, after taking this one clearly, now we can see now, in this case, we need to find a perpendicular, the bisector of PQ. That means at angle it is bisect must be which one at Q angle. Okay, Q angle we need to find bisector. This bisector we need to find out bisecting for which one at Q angle. Okay, this one we need to find out. Okay, this for example some S you can take SQ or anything you can take. Or AQ. AQ is the required bisector equation we need to find out. Here, what is the angle we'll meet? For that, find out slope of QR. Slope of QR. Okay. Well, finding slope of QR, x2 minus x1, that is 3 root 3 minus 0, 3 root 3 by 3. Now, slope nothing but m, that is tan theta. Tan theta is equal to root 3. Now, theta root 3 at which angle? Pi by 3. This angle clearly pi by 3. And this angle pi by 3, this whole angle is how much? 2 pi by 3. This angle how much here? 2 pi by 3. Now, it is bisecting now. This whole angle is 2 pi by 3 means here this angle also how much we get? Pi by 3. When this is pi by 3, this angle also pi by 3. This portal, again how much we get? 2 pi by 3. Okay. Now, this one bisecting, total angle how much here? Angle x QA is how much? 2 pi by 3 we can take. Now it is bisecting. That means this angle, that means QA makes angle with x axis how much? 2 pi by 3. That's why I can find out slope of QA. Slope of QA, how to find? That is tan 2 pi by 3 I can take. Tan 2 pi by 3 we can take in this case. Tan 120. Tan 120 means we can write tan pi minus pi by 3. That is minus tan pi by 3. Minus tan pi by 3. That is minus root 3 is the value. Okay. Now, it is clearly passing the which point? Origin only now. Slope already we know. equation of q, a passing through zero, m is equal to slope, how much we got? Minus 3. Y minus y1, 0 equal to m minus root 3 into x minus 0 is x. Minus root 3x take side, plus root 3x plus y is equal to 0. That's why which option is correct? Option 3 is the correct one. Okay, next. This is a solution. Now I'm clearing this. Okay, next. Move on, next one. Is an integration. Oh, yeah. In the 14, integral root 2 sub root of 1 plus sin x dx equal to minus 4 is root 2 common. We can take later. Now, this I can write root of sin square x by 2 plus cos square x by 2. Sin x I can write 2 sin x by 2 into cos x by 2. Into dx is equal to minus 4 cos of ax plus b plus whole c. Later we can take that one. Now first what you will do in this case here. Now root 2 into this whole I can write root of a plus b whole square cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2 whole square into dx. Right side you can compare later. Square root is cancelled. Now remaining what? Cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2 into dx. Integrate this root 2 into integral of cos sin x by 2 and inner function derivative 1 by writing denominator is comes to numerator. It's minus cos x by 2. Inner function derivative what you'll get by 1 by 2 plus c. This 2 will come to numerator 2 root 2 into sin x by 2 minus cos x by 2 plus c. Now I will take minus is common from this because we need in terms of cos. By taking minus common, what will get? 2 root 2 first cos value will come. Cos of x by 2 minus sin of x by 2 plus c. Okay. Now divide with into your root 2 ma and multiply with root 2. 2 root 2 into root 2 by dividing with root 2. Cos x by 2 into 1 by root 2 minus sin x by 2 into 1 by root 2 plus c. This is total minus 4. This is cos. This we can write. This I can write cos of pi by 4. This we can write sin of pi by 4. Now here cos A cos B minus sin A sin. That is cos of A plus B. That is x by 2 plus pi by 4 plus C we can take. Now this one compare with this right side answer. A value clearly 1 by 2. B value almost clearly pi by 4. That's why clearly we can take which option is correct. Option 1 is the correct one. Next, number 15. The tangent at any point on the curve, x power 4 plus y power 4 plus a power 4 cuts the intercept p and q on the coordinate axis. What is the value of p power 4? And q power minus 4 by 3. Okay, now first, what is the given curve? X power 4 plus y power 4 is equal to a power 4. Now I am differentiating this to find the slope of the tangent. Let the point I am taking for easy purpose. I am taking small x comma small y, okay? Condition wise. Now differentiating means what you will get? 4x cube plus 4y cube into y dash derivative is equal to 0. From this y dash you will get minus x cube by y cube. Now slope m is equal to same minus x cube by y cube. Now I am taking equation of tangent. This tangent is cuts x and y axis at p and q points. Intercept lengths are given, p and q. Let we can compare. Now I am taking equation of tangent. I am taking capital Y because small y are used. Y1 is nothing but y is equal to m nothing but minus x cube by y cube into capital X minus small x. Cross multiplication y cube into capital Y minus y power 4 is equal to minus small x cube into capital X plus x power 4. Okay, from this small x cube into capital X plus small y cube into capital Y, you send y power 4 right side. Now what we get here, x power 4 plus y power 4. Now your x cube into capital X, y cube into capital Y, this is how much clearly on the given curve, a power 4. Now we need to change this one into intercept form, x cube into capital X plus y cube into capital Y by a power 4 is equal to 1. Divide with a power 4 and send this x cube into denominator, capital X by, what is x intercept is, a power 4 by x cube, capital Y by a power 4 by y cube is equal to 1. Now this is P, this is Q. Okay, now P is equal to what here? A power 4 by x cube, Q is equal to a power 4 by y cube. From this, if you take the powers, conditioned by is, now what is our expectations? We'll get NC is. Okay, now, here further terms. Now, how will take values in this case? I am taking what here? P power minus 4 by 3 I am taking. Okay, P power minus 4 by 3. First, I will find out easy purpose. P power 4 by 3 only find. P power 4 by 3 means numerator becomes 16 by 3. Denominator 3, 3 cancel. What will get? X power 4. Okay. Q power 4 by 3 also similar manner. A power 16 by 3 by y power 4. Now, what they're asking basically here in this case, they're asking we need to find P power minus 4 by 3 plus Q power minus 4 by, this is called reciprocal of P power 4 by 3, reciprocal of Q power 4 by 3. Okay, now from this, what will get X power 4 by A power 16 by 3? First now, Y power 4 by A power 16 by 3. LCM is a power 16 by 3. Numerator x power 4 plus y power 4, that is a power 4. Now send this value into numerator. 12 minus 16, that is a power minus 4 by 3. That's why this option 1 is the correct one. 16th one, actually, as per this question, option 1 is correct. If you take above, only above means second option is correct. Okay. Now means we'll explain clearly. Now, what is a given curve? I'll find y square from that. X cube by 2a minus x. Here clearly, x must be less than 2a. Never take the values wise, and it must be lies in between 0. We can't take less than 0 also. You know, less than. Because 0 if you take also, what will happen? It's not defined total value. X value if you take the 0 also. X will be total value 0 will come, no problem. From 0 onwards we can take. Okay. Now, take not take a curve because y square is there, never positive in negative side. Now, to draw the graph, this now you take x value 0. If take x value 0, y also what we get? 0 only will come. Now, now in this x value 0, now if I take a, if I take x value a, what is y square is equal to a cube by 2a minus a, that is a square. Now y will get what here, plus r minus a. Okay, but it never touches 2a. Reason, if x value 2a, this whole is not defined. So it is an infinite line for given curve. It never touches this. Now it is reaches, this is plus a. This is minus a. Let us move on like this. It's also moving on this. We need to find, if they're asking, general area means we need to find both parts. Above part and below part. Two times, both are symmetric part. they're asking only above x-axis means one part is enough, then this is correct option. Then if they're asked not mention above, then we will take only first option. Okay. Now, area. For example, both parts, what I told, it's a whole area we need to find. Here two types of integral 0 to 2a, so extreme limit, okay? Somewhere it stretches well in different equation. The curve what? Y value find out from this y value, what we get? Square root of there. From this, y is equal to x power 3 by 2 by root of 2a minus x, okay? Directly we can't get area. Now to find that, to eliminate the square root, I'm substituting x is equal to 2a sine square theta. Okay, now differentiate this. Dx is equal to total 2a into 2 sine theta cos theta into d theta. This is total 4a sine theta cos theta d theta. Okay, now continuation. Now change the limits also as parallelly. X 0. 0 means so this also 0 will get. If x value 2a, x value 2a means 2a, 2a cancel. Sin square theta is equal to 1. Sin theta is scale how much? Pi by 2. So upper limit pi by 2 will get. And x power 3 by 2, that means 2a power 3 by 2 into sin square power 3 by 2, what will get here? Sin cube theta into dx is what? 4a sin theta into cos theta d theta divided by 2a minus x value 2a sin theta. Then 2a comes, that is root of 2a into root of what will get? 1 minus sin square theta. 1 minus sin square minus cos square. Root of cos square nothing but cos. So these two terms gets cancelled. Now we have 2 into integral 0 to pi by 2 x power 3 by 2 we can write x into root x. Like that, this we can write 2a into root of 2a sine to sine, sine total, this is a 4a sine power 4 theta divided by root of 2a. Root of 2a gets cancelled, this is d theta will get. Total is how much? 2, total 4, 8, 8, 2 is a 16. 16a square into integral 0 to pi by 2, what is the term? Sine power 4 theta into d theta. Now we have one formula. Integral 0 to pi by 2 sine power n theta d theta nx. So n is a even. N is a even condition. N by n minus 1. Okay. N by n minus, sorry, n minus 1. No? N minus 1 by n into n minus 3 by n minus 2. Until you add all odd factors and even factors until getting 1 by 2. After getting 1 by 2, right? Pi by 2. Okay. For odd also, same manner, but last you get 1 there. Okay. Here, n value how much? N value 4. That's why 16 a square into. Now, what I'm writing here, n. 4 minus 1, 3, pi 4. Next, 4 minus 3, 1. 4 minus 2, 2. 1 by 2 we got now. Similarly multiply with pi by 2. Now, here, 4 2s are 8, 8 2s are 16. That's 16, 16 cancel 3 pi a square. Now, because of extra, we got 2, because whole area we are finding. So, we got first option. They are asking only above area, we will not multiply 2, then by 2 extra will come. Okay. Next. Question number 17 is a linear differential equation divided with the denominator, divided with x square minus 1, and then we can simplify. We'll get answer easily. A linear differential equation dy by dx as py equal to q form. You can try. Okay. Next, 18th one. Question number 18. They given what here? F suffix n is equal to f of n minus 1 of x. Here, what is the meaning? If take f n value f 2 of x, what will you get? F of 2 minus 1, 1 f of x. What is f of x actually given? F of x given x only, now that's why again f of x, again x only will come. If you take f3 of x also, f of f2 of x. What is f2 of x? Again x. F of x nothing but x. That's why any number of times you'll take x only will come. That's why, what is the equation? F3 of x into F2 of x into F of x minus 25 F2 of x into F of x plus 175 F of x. I'm taking 375 also left side. Each one x only now. This is x, this also x, this also x. This is total how many times multiple? 3 times x cube minus 25 x square minus 175 x minus 375 equal to 0. Cubic equation, for this we need to find factors. Now what are the factors we'll get in this case? I am taking more multiples of 5, that's why I am taking x is equal to 5 in this case. Now this is divisible by 5, that's why I am taking 5 least value. Now coefficients 1, minus 25, 175, minus 375. Put 0 here, 0 plus 1, 1, 1 into 5, 5. This is minus 20, minus 100. This is 75. 75 5 is how much you'll get? 375. It's clearly what? 0. Okay, this completely what is a factor? X minus 5 into it is x square coefficient, x square minus 20x plus 75x equal to 0. This whole value, what we can take consideration in this case, we need to check in this case. Okay. Again, if you take x value 5 here, 5 square 25 is minus 100. So again, 5 is one more time factor. This total value, if you make factors, this will get x minus 5 into x minus 15, because 15 5 is 75, some minus 5 minus 15 minus 20. That's why factors are x values are what? 5 and 15. 5 and 15. That's why both first option and second options are correct. That's why option 4 is the correct one. Next. Question number 19. In question number 19, I'm taking each one individually. Take first one is integral factor. It is equal to integral sine square x into sine inverse of root t dt. Here, to eliminate the square root, I'm taking t is equal to, for example, in terms of sine only, I'm taking. Now to take the sine value, take simple value. Some sine square u, I'm taking u or x, whatever. X are there and don't take x. Now dt is equal to what you will get? 2 sine u cos u into du. Okay. Now this we can write total what? Sine t or 2u du. So dt. Now change the limits now. Limits means now t 0, sine 0 also what? Sine of 0, 0 will come. If t is sine square x, square cancel, sine x equal to sine u, that is x will get. Sine inverse of root t means what? From this we'll get root t nothing but only sine u. Sine inverse of sine u nothing but u, dt nothing but sine 2u du. Next I'm taking second term, I2. This I'll split into two parts. 0 to pi by 2 u sine 2u du. Next I will take pi by 2 to x. Pi by 2 to x, u sine 2u du. Second one, integral 0 to cos square x, cos inverse of root t dt. Now here again, I'm taking t some value in terms of cos. T is the sum. Can I cos square u only or b? No problem. It is not a matter. Symbol what you're taking. Finally, we get same notation only. It's not changing anything because t is same substitution. I change the limits now. Here also what we get? Tt is equal to cos square derivative 2 cos u, again cos derivative minus sine total minus sine 2u du will get. Okay. It is a t 0, cos 0. 0 means what you will get in this case? 0. Now 0 means cos 0 at which angle? Pi by. Cos square x means you will get x only in this case. This is clearly u into minus sine 2u d. This is how much? Minus integral pi by 2 to x u sine 2u du. This is which one? I2. Now I'll add I1 and I2. Okay. By adding I1 and I2, here already positive is there. This is negative. Both gets cancel. Now what remain you will get? Integral 0 to pi by 2 u sine 2u du. Now here onwards, after UV formula, integration by parts. This is capital U, this is V dash, and applying limits, we get answer is finally I by 4. Okay, next, question number 20. It is based on determinants concept. It is a homogeneous equation is given. Each equation a set of values of A for which system of linear equations has non-trivial solution. Non-trivial means non-zero solutions. Non-zero solution means delta is equal to 0. Okay. Now your first value coefficient root 2A sin B cos B. Next 1 cos B sin B. Next minus 1 sin B minus cos B is equal to 0. By expanding this, root 2a into cos square is minus cos square b minus sin square b. Minus sin b into 1 into minus cos, that is minus cos b minus of minus plus sin b. I am not explaining this all. Determinant expanded we know already. Cos b into sin b minus of minus plus cos b equal to 0. So root 2a minus common means cos square b plus sin square, that is 1 only. Minus multiply sin b into cos b minus sin square b. Next cos b into sin b plus cos square b is equal to 0. Now cos square b minus sin square b, cos 2b, sin b cos b, sin b cos b, 2 sin b cos b, that is sin 2b. These two terms adding sin 2b will get, these two sum will get cos 2b is equal to 0. Okay, now generally the notation root 2a or the whole equation divided with the root 2 ma, for easy purpose, this is minus a sin 2b. I'm converting into single function 1 by root 2 plus cos 2b into 1 by root 2 is equal to 0. From this, I'm writing sin of a plus b form, writing the sin of a plus b. Sin 2b into, I'm writing this 1 by root e is cos pi by 4 plus cos 2b into sin pi by 4. Okay. Now a is equal to, I'm sending minus a, that's it, plus a. This is completely what? Sin of 2b plus pi by 4. Sin function is equal to a means, what is the sin range? Minus 1 to plus 1. That's why a range also what? From minus 1 to plus 1 or we can write a is belongs to closed interval minus 1 comma 1. Okay. Next, coming to your numerical type questions. Question number 21. Two vertical poles, points 20 meters and 80 meters high, stand apart on a horizontal plane. Okay, if you start initial here, today this is the origin point. Okay, this is some length is reached. After reaching this height of the is how much? 80 meters. And this is A means, if you take this one is along the y axis. Is if you take along x axis, this point B becomes what here? A comma 0. This point C becomes x value A, y value 80. They're asking what? The height of point of intersection of lines joining top of each pole to the foot of the other. Here too, I'm joining foot of the other, second tower, here to first tower. Here, this is a point of intersection. From here, we need to find height. Okay? This point, we don't know exactly how much value. Now, I'll take, for example, this is a P, this is Q. If you assume this length is some X, this length X means this length is how much Y, then the Q point is X comma Y. Now P point is what? X comma 0. Here we need Y value only, okay, clear. Now at Q point, which are intersecting, if you know Q point, then Y value you get, now Y only required. Q point, which is, you take for example A point, AB line and OC line are intersecting. So I'll find out equation of OC. O nothing but origin 0, 0. Now same 2 points formula y minus y1 0 by y2 80 minus 0 80. So x minus x1 0 by a minus 0, that is a. From this y value, how much? 80x by a. Okay, this is one equation take. Next equation of AB. Now this is a 20 means. Now what is on y-axis if you take? Now this is present on x-axis. This is present on y-axis. A point is 0, 20. Same a is take first point. Y minus 20 by a. X2 is what here? 0. 0 minus 20 is minus 20. Next, x minus x1, that is 0 by a minus 0. Y minus 20 is equal to minus 20x by a. Y is equal to what? 20 minus 20x by a. Take LCM what? 20a minus 20x by a. Now from these two equations, by solving these two equations, now both side, left side, right side, denominator, left, y only there, now that's why I'm equating these two. A cancel, 100x is equal to 2a, so 20a. From this x value, what we get? 25, so that's why a by 5 will get. We need y value only, now. Y from first equation, 80x by a, 80 by a into x value, how much? A by 5. Now this is clear, how much 80 by 5 means 16. That's why 16 we should write here, okay, in numerical part. Next, question number 22. Question number 22, it's easy, ma. First to change this equation into standard form. For that, rationalize your denominator, and from that you'll get x value and y value. We can get easily this answer, okay. Next, coming to next one. 23. Now 2 rupee coins, 2 coins, 2 1 rupee coins, sorry. One rupee coins, 2 5 rupee coins, also 2 10 rupee coins, also 2. 20 rupee coins also. 2 coins are selected. Okay, first n of s. Total how many coins? 8. Out of 8, I'm selecting only 2. Okay. Here, requiring, for example, a is the even that. Two coins are randomly selected. Sum of 2 coins. More than equal to 20 or more than 20. More than 20 means so much you will get. So many possibilities are there. We can't find that values. For that, I am finding A bar means what? Less than meaning. That's why P of A we can find 1 minus probability of sum of 2 coins. Greater than equal to is complement is what? Less than 20. Less than 20, by adding 2 coins sum is less than 20, we need to hit possibilities. Possibilities are what? If you take 1 rupee only, 5 rupees only if you take, 10 rupees if you take, what will happen? 10 comma 10. Great, it is more than exactly 10 is coming. Okay, that also we don't want in this case. Okay, you see next possibility. 1 rupee, 1 5 rupee coin. 1 rupee, 1 10 rupee coin. Okay, now next possibilities. Getting iterate all combinations. 2 coins means randomly selecting the any order is possible. Maybe first one, second one, like that. See what are the possibilities will come. Okay, now. Okay, now less than 10 possibilities I'm getting. 1, 1, that's a 1, 1 coin, 1 rupee coin, 2 times taken. 1 rupee, 5 rupee, ₹1, ₹10. Next, 5 rupees both kinds sum less than 10. Next, if you take 5, 10. 5, 10. Or 1 10 rupee coin and 1 5 rupee coin is not equal. Any combination same only, no issue. Okay. Now, take in that 10, 10 total almost 6 now, but this is extra. Now what we are taking? Allocations. Here, out of 6, this is the probability of, for example, this is A bar. Out of 6, we will take select C2. Still, you need combinations. Yeah, I'll tell you, see all of you. A P of A bar, I'm going to, this is completely under A bar conditions. Here I'm taking what combination? Out of these coins only, I'll select two. Okay, favorable 6C2. But in that, 10, 10 also will come. But 10, 10 sum is how much? 20 will come. But to when it gets less than 2, that's why. From that, we need to remove 2 10s we selected out of 2 coins. From 2 10 coins, we selected 2 coins. That is not required. That's why by total how much? 8C2. This is the combination we are taking values here. 8C2 means 8 into 5 by 2. That is 15. 2C2 means 1. 8C2 means what? 8 into 7 by 2 into 1. 2 ones are 2 fours are. This is clearly 14 by 28, 1 by 2. Now the required probability P of A is equal to 1 minus this whole value 1 by 2. 1 minus 1 by 2 is what? 1 by 2. That's why in these 6 coins, we select 2 coins. But 10 is other combination, it will be satisfied, but this is extra coin, okay? That we need to remove, okay? 1 by 2. 1 by 2 means what? We can write like exactly means 0.50, like that we can. Next, 24 theta 1 is given, how much? Pi by 2008, theta 2, 10,003 pi by 2008, add theta 1 and theta 2. Adding these two, what will get? 1004 pi by 2008. Now, this is clearly how much will get? Pi by 2. Now, from this given question, theta 1 to theta 2 d theta by 1 plus tan theta. Take this term as I. Now I is equal to, I'm applying property now, integral a to b f of x dx is equal to integral a to b f of a plus b minus x dx. It's easy by applying property theta 1 plus theta 2. Now d theta by 1 plus tan of theta 1 plus theta 2. Minus theta. Theta 1 nothing but how much? Pi by 2. Theta 1 plus theta 2. No, that's why I am directly writing pi by 2 minus theta. Okay. Integral theta 1 to theta 2 d theta by 1 plus this whole value cot theta will get. Now I is equal to this, take it as equation 1 mark. Later we can take this one. Now integral theta 1 to theta 2 cot theta we can write 1 by tan theta. Just by taking LCM. Numerator tan theta will get, remaining denominator same, tan theta plus 1 into d theta. Now observe in first and second, integral limits are same, denominator also same. Now left side we can add 2y is equal to integral theta 1 to theta 2, denominator what we can take? 1 plus tan theta, numerator also what? 1 plus tan theta d theta. Both gets cancelled, remaining integral of d theta, that is theta, from where to where? Theta 1 to theta 2. Substitute upper limit theta 2 minus theta 1. Theta 2 nothing but how much? 103 pi by 2008 pi. Total how much will get? 1003 minus 1001 will get. Total 1002 pi by 2008. So much 2 pi. We need I value. They given already 501 pi by k. They given. I'm dividing with 2 cancellation. 2 ones are 2 501s. Okay. Now I is equal to what? pi naught 1 pi by 2008. Now this one compare with answer. Now what is the k value clearly? 2008. That's why you should enter here what? 2008. Next 25. The expansion of 1 plus x whole power n. The consecutive terms are there. Now coefficients are in the ratio 1:2:3. Means nck is 2, nck plus 1 is 2, nck plus 2 is equal to 1:2:3. We need to find all sum of all possible values of n and k. First take nck by nck plus 2 is equal to k plus 1. What ratio is there? 1:2. Nck, ncr formula, n factorial by n minus k factorial into k factorial divided by same n factorial by n minus k minus 1 factorial into k plus 1 factorial is equal to 1/2. N factorial cancel. This term comes to numerator. N minus k minus 1 factorial. K plus 1 factorial we can write. K plus 1 into k factorial by n minus k, if we expand, what will get? N minus k minus 1 factorial into k factorial 1/2. K factorial cancel, n minus k minus 1 factorial cancel, cross multiplication 2, what will get here? 2k plus 2 is equal to n minus k. Now k is in this side, minus k. 3k plus 2 is equal to n. Just take it as 1. Similarly, take another ratio. What is the ratio? Nck plus 1 by nck plus 2 is equal to what? 2/3. Now by simplifying this, by expanding this value, equation, that equation will get, from that we can find easily what the equation will get. Means I'll tell you now, the equation is 5k plus 8 is equal to 2n. You will get, substitute n value, we get k value is 4 and n value is 14. So sum of these two values they're asking, n plus k, that is 18 is the answer. Not solving this again, method understood na? You try. Okay, next. 26, the mean and standard deviation of 6 observations. Okay, starting the mean, old mean 8, old standard deviation. How much 4? Now this is nothing but square of standard square. It just becomes a variance that we know already. Now if each observation is multiplied by 3, the new standard deviation is, now generally 3 into x bar. How much will get? 24. This is now new one. So much new one. Now this is a new one, generally new x bar. Now coming to standard deviation, nothing but squaring of square of this. Taking square of this value, later we can take. Now by multiplying 3 for each observation, now I'll find variance. New variance I am taking. Okay. New variance, that is each observation multiplied with 3. 3 square, x square, that is 3. 9 will come and will come. That's why xi square rise from 1 to 6. By 6 is as usual. Minus mean square now. So mean square means, for that also 3 multiplied by 3 square, how much will get? 9 x bar whole square will get. General notations. That's what notations. For total, I'll take 9 is common from this. I take 9 is common. Remaining what will get? Summation I is equal to 1 to 6. Say square by 6. This is x bar whole square value you can take. X bar, as for old one, what is the old one? Old one only can take. How much it is? 8. Summation I is equal to 1 to 6. Say square by 6. 8 square. What about this original value? In this, what is the meaning of this? Squaring on this one means what we get? So variance. Variance is equal to how much? 16. As for that, if we take notation wise, so old variance we can take directly. This old variance is a same formula will come. Old variance how will get? Summation I is equal to 1 to 6. Xi square by 6 is equal minus x bar whole square. Okay, now so old variance only we can take, that is 16 we can take as is. We are not to simplify. Keep x bar only whole square. This is which one? Old variance. 9 into 16. This is which one? 144. They are asking new standard deviation. Old variance, new variance we got now. That's why new standard deviation is nothing but square root of variance of new and new variance. So root of 144, that is how much? 12. I take 9 common because 9 is common possible in both from mean and this expression. That's why this total value becomes which one? Old variance only. Okay, old variance already how much we got? 16. That's why need to enter what here? 12. Next, this also based on limits 7. Limit extends to 0, tan x into root of tan x, or to get easily this value. Now this generally x into root x we can write, x into root x in how, which form will write clearly, we can write x power 3 by 2. Same manner, this I can write tan x power 3 by 2. This also I can write sine x power 3 by 2. To change this one into tan, take common, I'm dividing with cos x power 3 by 2, dividing and multiplying. Okay? Whole divided by this, how much will get? X power 3 by 2, x power 3 into x power 1 by 2. It's total x power 7 by 2 will get. This x power 7 by 2, I can write x power 3 by 2 into x square. This also gives 7 by 2 only. So this total value, x power 7 by 2, later we can take this one. Now from this, limit x tends to 0, I'm taking tan, this whole value tan only now. So tan 3 by tan power 3 by 2 x common, remaining 1 minus cos power 3 by 2 x. Whole power means we can write like that. By this x power 3 by 2, I'm writing 7 by 2 is x power 3 by 2 into x square. Now this limit extends to 0, tan x by x whole power n, it is 1 only, this by this complete value becomes 1 into remaining what? 1 minus cos power 3 by 2 x by x square. Directly substituting limit what? Which form will get? 0 by 0 form. Reason, cos 0 is 1, 1 minus 1, 0 by 0 form. That's why I'm applying L-Hospital rule. Okay? We know how to apply L-Hospital rule. That is limit extends to 0. Now derivative of numerator, 1 derivative 0 minus cos derivative. Cos power 3 by 2, 3 by 2. Cos power 3 by 2 minus 1 is 1 by 2. And again cos derivative what? Minus sin x. Divided by x square derivative is what? 2x. Here minus into minus plus 3. This 2 also comes to denominator 3 by 4 into cos x power 1 by 2 into remaining what? Sin x by x. Now apply limit now, 3 by 4, cos 0, 1, limit extends to 0, sin x by x is 1. Now finally, what is the answer here? 3 by 4, but numerical I will try, this is 0.75. Okay? Next, 28. Three people each flip two fair coins. The probability that exactly two of people flipped with one head and one tail. Okay. How many persons are throwing the two coins? Three persons. That's why number of trials, Bernoulli trials, number of trials is three you can take. Your probability of success is what? Probability of success. That nothing but you will take a P symbol. P is equal to getting one head or one tail. One head and one tail must compulsory. How many you want? Two. Two times means what? Four. That is 1 by 2. The property of failure. This also how much you get? 1 by 2. Because Q nothing but 1 minus P. Now, number of success what here? Exactly two of people flipped one head and one. That means two times we need to get success. Number of success is 2. So, P of X is equal to R. probability distribution. What is the formula? NCR, p power n minus r, q power r. Now here p of x is equal to 2, n is what? 3, c 2, p value 1 by 2, 3 minus 2, that is 1, q is 1 by 2 power 2, 3 c 2, nothing but 3 c 1, so 1 by 2 to this total, 1 by 8, 3 by 8, 3 by 8 is how much we get? 0.38 will get, that we need to enter here. Okay, next. What is next one? P of S denotes the set of all subsets of given set S. Then the number of 1-1 functions from S to P of S. P of S nothing but power set. Set of all subsets we called as power set. First, how many elements? S is given now. What is S? 1, 2, 3. N of S is 3 clearly. P of S, number of subsets formula, 2 power N formula, okay? So 2 power N means number of elements in set. That is 8. Now we need to find number of 1-1 function. Generally what you will do, now 1-1 functions is possible when the number of elements in set A must be less than or equal to number of elements in set P. Number of elements in set A is less than or equal to number of elements in set B. Then only 1-1 functions are possible. Clear. Now, okay. Now, your number of elements, what? We know number of 1-1 functions. Now, formula we have already for this condition, number of 1-1 functions. Generally, what formula? N of B, P, N of A. Here, N of B, nothing but what? Number of elements in P of A. That is 8P3. 8P3, how to do? 8 into 7 into 6. Only 3 number decrease, enough. So how much will come? 336. That is the answer. Okay. Next. Last problem. 90. Now what is the, that is a 30 ma. So that. The given equation 2 secant 4 c plus sine square 2 a plus root of sine b is equal to 0. That means the ABC triangle satisfy this. That means which angles will satisfy? For example, we'll take angle A is 45 degrees. Angle B is 90 degrees. Angle C is also 45 degrees. You check once if you want. Secant 4 into 45, 360. Secant 360, 1, no problem. 2. Here, how much will get? Secant square of 90, that is 1. 4 c na, 4 into 45, 90, 180 means secant 180 minus 1. That's why minus 2 is 6. This is 1 we'll get. So yes, sine 90 also 1. 1 plus 1, 2. 2 minus 2, 0. That's why this angles will be satisfied. So here is a right angle, isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle. One more thing, point B taken on the longest side. Longest side, angle B is here. A, this is C. P on longest side of triangle divides the side in the ratio 1 is to 3. Here, for example, 1 ratio means remaining part ratio is 3 ratio. Okay. That QR is the circumcenter and ortho center. We know clearly it is a lies on in right angle triangle clearly. The ortho center located at right angle only. Okay, next notation. And we know this circumcenter is always locating at where? It's locating at midpoint of hypotenuse. So really bisects at exactly perpendicularly. This both lengths are equal. Clear. Now the value wise. Now what we are taking notation side. Notations. The angle is 45. If for example, if you take this is A length. If this is A, what about this also? A only will come. Reason. Take tan 45 degrees. Right angle triangle, you know, opposite is BQ by adjacent is AQ. It's one BQ if you don't know. AQ already we assumed A. So BQ also A1 will get. Here this is clearly midpoint of this. The midpoint of this means it is also dividing in a same ratio, 1:1 ratio. This is 2 units, here also 2 units will come always. When this is A, this also must be here. We need to take a general notations wise. Okay. Now, when this is A, I'm joining these two also. PP has one notation. Whatever this term will get, because here BQ bisects AC. Because there is a circumcenter. This is an orthocenter. Here we need to find the ratio. All the given PQ is to QR is to RP. That ratio we need to find. That lengths are required. A BQ is not a matter. Okay, BQ we got. Next, we need BP. Before finding BP, we need this length. Okay, now the value wise. And this complete length A means this length must be A by 2. This length also must be A by 2. Because circumcenter is midpoint of that. I said clearly. That's why if this is A by 2, this right angle triangle only, which one? Triangle PQB. Right angle triangle. The length wise, this is the length also. How much will you get? A by 2 only we will get. Okay. As well as triangles will satisfy. Here also same notation. This also how much will you get? A by 2 will get. That's why PP is how much will you get? A by 2. The length wise will get. Okay. PQ also A by 2 rotation wise. Now clear in this case. Now we need to find RP. That was RP value. Find RP. Now RP if you want to find out. Now from triangle with the same combination. RPQ. Now RP square. PR square or RP square. Don't think B and C are locating the same, but the length variant. See now. RP square is equal to BQ square plus PQ square. PQ means A square. This is A square by 4. So total 5 A square by 4. Now RP is equal to root 5 A by 2. Now next, which length we required PQ? PQ already we know. PQ length already we got. Next, which length required QR? QR already. QR and BQ same, that's A, no problem. That's why now I am taking that ratios. PQ is to QR is to RP is equal to 1:1 alpha is to beta. PQ length is what? A by 2. QR length is how much? QR and QB is the same, that is A. RP length is what? Root 5 by 2. Okay. It's equal to 1:1 alpha is to beta. Here A is cancelled common factor. Take LCM 1:1, 2:1 root 5. It's equal to 1:1 alpha is to beta. This alpha value to beta value root 5. Okay. Now, condition wise, what we are taking in this case values. Now they're asking which one? Alpha square plus beta. So there is 4 plus 5, that is 9 is the answer we need to enter. Okay. Thank you, students.